Hello everyone and welcome back to another Bed Wars video. I somehow just lost the words to say that for some reason. I'm just going to be playing some normal games again today because I think the last three videos, or maybe even more, were just some like showing you stuff and some kind of compilations. So I want to play some normal games again. So that's what we're going to do today, and let's get going on our first rush here. Oh boy, oh boy. Boy, oh boy, what? Oh, come on. I mean, I still have 46 blocks, but that is not what I signed up for with the first rush. Oh my, come on. I cannot lose. And, oh, my bed does have a defense, okay. It's me, the DK you'll know and love, that fails his first rush against someone who builds up straight from their base like that. Ooh, baby. Let's see. Yeah, they don't know how to stop block movement with blocks, so this shouldn't be too bad. And I actually got the bed just after the other bed that got destroyed. No, just before even, wow. Still got that. I still have it, I still got it. No, was that aqua or white? White is... aqua's gone, so it must be white, okay. Now I should also be able to collect 8 diamonds right here, because the people that have the rush right there, which is yellow and green as I see right now, aren't done with their rush, so I hope no one came here. Which wouldn't surprise me, knowing the typical Bed Wars player. And maybe I'll just do the risky thing and almost fall off. No, I'm gonna go to green here and try and use my diamonds there and get a bed at the same time. They just killed yellow, so they're not gonna respawn here. Gonna break that bed and then keep going. That's sharp trap and prot. Nothing more, just sharp trap and prot. Now, yellow is still alive because they killed green, and now I'm gonna hopefully be able to kill yellow here. They disconnected. That is really lame. I think I'm gonna avoid at this point. I think that's the best course of action because I would have to go to mid, and I guess my next rush is over there. Yeah, I still think going back to base is the best idea. I'm gonna have to... maybe it wasn't actually, because now I have to go all the way across the map. I concede it was not a good idea. So I hope white is not gonna be too much of an issue, but I just fell into the void previously. I saw that they were building like a 4-5 layer bed defense, so I'm not too worried right now. And also pink just got, like, pink and grey, one got the other's bed. They're still fighting, so I'm not gonna go in quite yet. For them, I think I'm gonna go for white first. Oh gosh, what's that? I heard an explosion. And pink is gone. Okay, I'm gonna go for white anyway. Because they also been collecting emeralds here, and I don't really like that. I'm gonna play risky and just keep my diamonds on me for now. Yep, didn't matter at all. Got this. Yep, that was not a smart move. Yeah, I can hit you there, you cannot, because I can move forward and you can't come into me. Also, I didn't talk during that. Yeah, that was way too intense. I'm sorry about that. Anyway, I can get Prot 2 here. And since this map is so big and you have to go so far to get to another base, I don't think my bed is in danger. Although it might be if they just, if they rush the wrong way, like if they go from... so wait, that's grey. So grey would have to go to red and then through me. So they could just build a bridge to red. Which doesn't make sense, generally. Maybe on this map that's actually not too stupid. And I could very well imagine Bed Wars playing doing that. Never mind, he's going to mid. That is very... that's very good for me. All I'm gonna say to that, and let's... whoa, sir? Please? Thank you very much. Goodbye. Why? Did he just spawn that golem, or was that already there? I can hear the golem walking. Oh boy. I'm out of here. Never mind, I guess I'm really out of here. Okay. I'll be back. So just to explain, like, what terrible thing I did there, what I was trying to do is fireball the golem and at the same time fireball myself back up to the platform I had built, like the piece of bridge that I had built over his base right there, you know, where I built up to protect myself from him, but that kind of backfired, in the most literal sense of the word. Yeah, no, you're not gonna use a KB stick on me. Awesome, let's go into the next game, GG. And here we are in the second game of Inca. I have to say, I actually quite like the new maps with a lot of iron. You just have to really pay attention, even on your first rush, not to run into someone that uses fireballs immediately. I've had that on Inca, I think I did that on a stream at some point recently. And god, it's annoying. And I think I actually lost... did I lose my bed? No. I think in the end, I killed them once, and they killed me twice with like fireballs, and then I just gave up because I killed them once. So it ended all well, but you just have to pay attention to fireballs. First bed is mine. Will you come out? Can I fire here? Please. Well, it works for me. Doesn't look like the block placements really did much, but I still won that fight. Alright, so I'm the second one that got a bed. White also got a bed, or whoever's next to white, because white's gone. I'm gonna go to the diamond gen now and just keep moving. Oh gosh, I hope Grey didn't get the die. They did not fall down, that is very bad. Why did they not go for the first rush over there? I don't understand. Wow, that worked out really nicely. Did not actually mean to block trap in there, but we'll just say that that was my plan, right? We'll just say that. And yes, axe is awesome to get to. I didn't actually know that you could actually break the block when they were falling into the void with an axe. I was pretty sure already, but you know, it's good to know that you can. I'll keep on moving to pink because I see why Grey didn't really attack pink, and I don't understand why pink either hasn't left or hasn't increased the size of their bed defense. Because what else would you do if you're just staying inside your base all the time? I guess now they're going to the diamond gen. This is a very interesting bed defense, I must say. I almost walked off into the void myself there. I still don't have any diamond upgrades, which I would really like to get. So I think I'm only able to get those at white here. And then I'll also be able to keep on moving to the person that did their first rush really quickly. And go to Aqua here. And think, yeah, Aqua's not seeing me. And they're also really laggy. But they're gone now. Anyway, whoa, what is going on today? Please, move away. Move away from the bridge and me. And they're already incoming, and I don't really want to fight them here. You see? So I'm just gonna... Why did I not... Come on! I see the particles, just... Or you can just jump down. That is very helpful, thank you very much. I only lost one absorption heart, so this should be quite easy here. Oh, never mind, they have spawn prods. But we won that. Awesome. Stick. GG. Alright, let's move in the last game. I think I'm gonna... Yeah, three games should be cool. And we're in the last game. So I'm gonna do what I haven't really said in a very long time. I think this game is gonna be easy because there weren't too many high levels in the lobby. But Hypixel has started to spoof levels, like Hypixel levels that you can query through the... like from their API. So it might just display as such, and they might still be a nick, so... And I definitely didn't look for nicknames, because I do not know what those look like, because I don't have MVP myself, so... Like, I don't know how they're generally constructed. I also hope 56 blocks is enough to get all the way over to someone else's base on Airshow, this is. For some reason, you know, I always think, you know, there's balloons, and there's something to do with that, and I often still forget what it's called. Yeah, please. Oh, come on, that was so close. Can I stash this and kill them? Come on, they're invisible. Come on. Oh, come on, Hypixel. Are you kidding me? There's no way I didn't hit them there. I must have stood somewhere where I hit them. Oh, wow. That really reminds me of one of my last videos. Well, last videos. It was a while back, but anyway, like, one of my past videos where I lagged out, and then I basically lost the whole game and I had to sweat the whole time. just because I lagged out on my very first run. Alright, I'm gonna get a prot here and the trap, and then I'm gonna bank everything and jump in the void because I'm way too low on health. Alright, so I've decided to go for white here. I don't know where white is. They were in the, oh, they're in the base, okay. I was gonna say they're not in the base, but they are actually in the base. Let me just do this and then this. Whoa! Yeah, okay, yeah. That is where you see that full damage really comes in handy, because I got the damage tick from them, but for some reason the damage tick that I got myself from full damage somehow eliminated the other one, even though they were quite apart. It really worked out. Now, am I getting rushed over there? Doesn't look like it, but yeah, green and blue are already done. Well, I'll take it, you know. I'll take not getting rushed. But I'm gonna void here because I don't want to get rushed, as I said. And why is... what is yellow doing through there? What the heck? Is yellow trying to go for me? Oh, what? Oh, pink. What is pink? Did I say... I don't know. Was that yellow? Is yellow even... yellow's not even alive, so it was... I mistook the yellow skin for yellow team. Yellow leather armor, but I'm gonna kill them here. And they were final. Yeah, that does make sense. A lot of sense if they were just running around randomly, if they didn't have a bed anymore. But yeah, they were too close to me and I didn't like that, so I had to eliminate them. Would have been a lot smarter to go back to their base, which is granted all the way across the map, but still. Alright, let's see if I can go on a 3-win streak in that video here. Because I started out actually in the first game and I would have got my first rush if I hadn't just walked off. So let's see if we can keep on going here and not lose this game. Since this is the last one, it would be really nice if I could get this in one recording. All done with, perfect games. Oh nice! Green is dead and red has emeralds. I do not like that. And they have a 2-layer bed defense, which means maybe obby. Me no likey. Me no likey at all. Okay, can I go in here directly? They did greet me already. I don't think they see me though. And they pearled out, yep. They have way too many emeralds, and I do not like that at all. They went invis, great. I have no clue where they are because they probably took jump too. I can't see any footstep particles. Oh gosh, they might have already gone mid. I don't like this. I'm gonna go mid and see if there are any emeralds missing. Did I just see something moving in the corner of my eye? Of course, yep. I knew it. How did they get over there? I didn't know you could do that with jump. And I only have 10 blocks left. Oh boy. I do not like this. I do not like this situation because they could be coming in any minute and just slaughter me out of nowhere. Buy some fireballs so I can fireball their face. Don't ask me why I just bought multiple knockback sticks. It all makes sense, okay, it all makes perfect sense in my head. And now I just want to know where they are. Have they gone back to mid? It's like one of the worst things in Bed Wars, if you have no clue where your enemies are. It's like the most dangerous situation you can be in. Ah, God. Yep, exactly. As I was saying, no! Oh, come on. Well, that's too bad. That's really unfortunate. I'm sorry, but I tried to re-record another 2 games and see if I could actually win those, but for some reason I can't seem to win anymore because I always have people that fight me with sharp iron swords and completely destroy me. So, I'm gonna have to end the video here. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Cheerio!